Hey guys, I'm Luis Duarte, 3D artist, and in this tutorial, I'll teach you how to create a cartoon character using Character Creator. To get us started, we bring a plane from the scene panel. We position it behind our male avatar, like so. Then, we scale it to a more proportional size. Next, we load a drawing from the texture panel. This dude is going to be our character concept. He'll be our guide to adjust the shapes and proportions of the model. I'm going to bring the reference closer to our avatar and bring it to the center. This will just help me stay on reference a little bit better, because references like this should always be as accurate as possible. Now we're going to use tools from the morph sliders. There's a lot to choose from. There's a morph slider for pretty much every segment or muscle group of our character. Every single avatar made via Character Creator allows for making these types of modifications. You can get pretty granular, pretty specific here, which really facilitates the design process. So, we can pose our guy here using the pose editor and put him in the same position as the drawing. Then I'll keep kind of playing with him until I get the proportions more or less similar. You know, we can get like 50 or 60% match to our character just using the morph tools like this. It's all up to your unique creative vision. What do you want your character to be like? There's no wrong answers. Just slide the morphs back and forth until it looks quote unquote right to your eyes. So I'll keep modifying until I'm happy. The big areas to focus on are hands, legs, torsos, the arms, to give them some biceps. Adjust the neck and the head, but always keeping in mind that our reference is approximate. We don't have to be exact at this stage. I did a ton of little tweaks here to the arm pose. Now I'm really zoning in on his face just to make sure I can get his proportions right. There's no exact science to this, just intuition. This guy has some expressive features. So it's super important to get the facial features right. In this case, we'll make sure the nose is broad and strong. We'll make the head slightly larger so it keeps that cartoony style. And we'll square off the jaw. Last but not least, we'll make sure his lips are nice and full like the reference. I'm focusing here on playing with the upper lip so it's nice and personalized. I think the nose could be more prominent too, so I'll scale that up as well. Bajoop. Broaden it a bit more. And finally, let's look at the torso. The reference is actually wider across the midsection, but that's fine. I'll do a tweak on the fingers here. I'll go back to Pose Editor and hit Default to get my T-pose, so I can double check all the changes I made and I can keep going to the next step. Looking pretty good so far. Next, I select the model, and holding Shift, I select the eyes and teeth as well. And I press the Go Z button. Then I confirm. So in ZBrush, the idea is to finesse and personalize our design, such that we match the reference image even better. We can do that with sculpting techniques, yay! We can actually take advantage of the fact that this guy here is low poly. I'll use the Move brush, but before that, I'll activate Smooth UV from the Geometry menu. Then I'll activate Symmetry by pressing X. Finally, I activate Dynamic Subdivision. With this, we can soften all those unnecessary details that our model has. Because we're doing a cartoony character, we just don't need all these sharp, defined details. So I'll smooth out the abs. That central part and the obliques as well. All these details, by the way, are coming stock from the avatar, and they're just not necessary for this type of cartoony aesthetic. With the brush, pressing Shift, I take a look around the body, and I'm softening and smoothing. The next thing I'm going to do is round the muscles out a little bit. For this, I'll use the standard brush with various intensities. You know, it's up to you to get what you're going for. We can tweak the proportions for all of our characters' muscles. I recommend doing a pass over the whole body. You should pay special attention to the main defining features of your character to get what you want, which generally would be a smooth and cartoony look. We'll repeat the process for our arms, torso, and our abdomen. Here we're going to go over the pectorals, which are definitely a defining feature of this guy. I'm going to add some subdivisions. You have to disable the dynamic subdivision to do this, and you're going to want to activate symmetry to speed up your work. You can use the cut brush, or any other brush really, that gets the look that you're going for. Here, I want to create a border with the mesh, or make a kind of beveling. This will give me a better definition of details with more clarity. I want to define certain areas here in the same way they'd look as if they were drawn in 2D. All right, once this is done, we'll go back to Character Creator. I also did some extra work, like here I added some definition to the fingernails and also a little bit on each of the limbs. So I'm going to select the body and hit the All button. We're going to send this back to Character Creator. In the Options window here, I untick this box and hit the Update button to load all the details. Looking good. Let's go to the Adjust Bones panel. And for the body, I'll select Auto Position. As well as for the face, you guessed it, we're going to go Auto Position on that one as well. Now, I'll go back to the main editor. I'm going to the Content folder and I'm looking for a pose. Any old pose will do, just click and drag it out. And in this way, see, we can verify that everything is looking right. Mainly that the body is working, and if you're using any clothes, that those look proper as well. I'll return to the default pose, and now I'm going to try making some poses and movements directly with the joint controls. You can do this on one side, or you can activate the mirror box here and verify that everything's looking good on the opposite side as well. You can even do this with the legs. Perfection! Everything's looking nice and fresh. Let's go back to ZBrush, and we'll activate the skin shader material. And then we'll try to locate a nice key color for our skin. Try to make it close to the shade we've got there in our reference drawing. He's got this nice burnt sienna, or maybe it's somewhere between raw and dark sienna. He's got hints of an umber shade and a little bit of a pink blush. The idea in this case is to use ZBrush to do what's known as poly painting. I'll activate the RGB mode and check the Fill Object box. Then, with a standard brush, disabling Z-Add, I'm going to enlarge the brush size a little, and I'll start to apply some color. This'll darken the skin tone. I recommend setting a subdivision level to 6 or 7. I think that'll capture a nice color. And in this way, I can start to paint, just directly over areas that should be dark, to highlight the cavities, or you can highlight the ridges of our character. Beyond that, he's cartoony. We're not going for realism. We're going for something vibrant and cartoony. Adding these touches will really help the final product stand out. He'll be distinctive with a hint of realism, but he'll still retain that cool animated style of the reference. So get creative. You can see here, I've got this nice umber undertone. And by poly painting, I've added this nice blush to his skin tone to highlight areas like the lips, the eyebrows, etc. Next up is Polyframe. Select it from the Transform menu, and here we can verify that all the UVs are represented properly. Then I press Ctrl-Alt-Shift and click to hide the geometry of the body and leave me with just the head. I click New from Polypaint here, Clone Texture, and then I export it. This process is nice and simple, and it's a good way to get textures directly from ZBrush, taking advantage of all the character creator models and their UVs. So the idea now is simply to do this process again and again. You're going to repeat this procedure for your remaining UVs. In this case, there are 5 in total if we include the nails. I know it's a lot of clicking, but you'll get there. Very good! Fantastic! Looking great! Next up, let's turn off the color, make the model this blank white, and I'm gonna generate a normal map. I do this with subdivisions set to 1. Again, I start with the head. I go to the normal map option, and I select Create Normal Map. It'll take a couple of seconds. Then I clone the normal map, and I export it. You can see that this texture is violet. It generates nice high poly details. And I repeat that procedure for all the remaining sections. I go to the torso. I generate it. Clone it. And I export it. And of course, we name it so we have everything nice and organized. I like to use these as PNGs. It's up to you. If you need to edit it, you can do that in Photoshop. You can do it a little bit in Character Creator as well. Just let me finish up here. Perfect. So back to Character Creator. I'll go to the texture panel and replace the main maps here. Base color first. See this shine? That can actually be a little bit too much, right? He's shiny, he's sweating. You can correct that from the roughness. You can right-click, adjust the color, and adjust the saturation and the brightness. Tweak these values more or less so your model doesn't look so strange. Then load the normal map. And voila, he's pretty close. I'll adjust the diffuse color just a little bit. I'm just tweaking to taste here. I'll adjust the saturation of the base color. You know what? He's looking even better. Dude, he's almost done. So now rinse and repeat the process. I'll import the body texture. Then I import the normal map. Remembering to activate the normal map box there. And I need to correct the roughness here as well. So each new part matches the first. You got to adjust the saturation, base color. It's the same procedure. You know, you have to repeat each step for each of the body sections. You want it to be uniform all over the skin tone. The character, he might end up covered up with clothes, but it's always important to create a design that you can reuse in different ways later, like both the skin and the shape of the body for your future projects. So. Lots of clicking. Finally, we'll do it to the legs, always keeping in mind, you got to adjust the brightness and saturation. For the curious case of the eyelashes. Here's something fun. I right-click, and then in color settings, I bring the base color to black. Then I'm going to substitute the opacity map for this new opacity with a more uniform look, and it's only on the upper eyelashes. For the eyes, let's switch to PBR mode. This will make them look a bit toonier. And finally, we'll load a new texture, a nice, simple one. put it on the eye, as well as on the cornea mesh here. We're picking one that isn't as realistic looking, but it has a sharper color to it. It's a bit more stylized. So these maps can be edited in Photoshop or ZBrush if you need. The eye's normal map here, I'm just going to fill in with the one violet color to remove that kind of bump detailing it has. And now what's left is to repeat the procedure with the rest of the textures to achieve this uniformity that we're looking for. Don't mind me, just got to do a bunch of clicking again. You know, we can also add a roughness map. The black of the roughness will make it shiny, and the white will keep it matte. You can see he's shaping up pretty good. Perfect. Let's change the opacity of the roughness. Maybe give it a value of, say, 31, more or less. And we'll do the same with the other cornea. This will just make the eye shine a bit more subtle and a bit more cartoony. So, banga banga bongo, already our avatar dude is basically ready. His textures are looking good, so we can save it as a CC project with his name. You should always save your work. And also, let's save him as a CC character. First, let's give him a nice pose, one that suits his personality, something cool and casual like this. Or something standard. And then I'll go to the content menu, and from the avatar button, I'll go to custom. We can even change the background to make him match Chloe and the other Simon there. From the project menu, I'll select background color and change that to white. I'll zoom in a bit on our guy, then in the content window, I'll hit that plus button, give him his name, and we can also change his position or pose a little bit to make a better thumbnail if we want. Just move some stuff around, right-click his character here, and choose Capture Thumbnail. Perfect! So the next really cool thing, this is the big thing that we can do, is we can create a head morph and a body morph. I'll go to the Create menu, and I start with the head, give it a name, and I press OK. Boop! So I'll repeat the process for the body. I'll give him his name so he knows who he is. He is Simon. So to show you how this works, I'll make a new project. And with our default lady there, I'll go to the Morph library. Then I hit the Reset button. And now for the head and the body, in the search bar, I put the name of my morph. And slide it to the right. As you can see, it applies perfectly. Don't need these right now. Now I look for the head morph. And I slide that to the right as well. So our new morphs here can even be combined with any other morphs. For example, you could do this. If you're feeling crazy, you could add a little bit of this. Give him big, beefy arms. And in this way, you can have a brand new character. In fact, let's add some clothes from our library. Just click and drag something out. I don't know if he's a pants guy. He seems more like he's a shorts guy. He overheats a lot. Oh, yeah, perfect. Let's find him a shirt. So, as you can see, this is a very simple and a very powerful procedure. Thank you for watching.